From a legal perspective, there are a couple of very interesting subjects that we have managed to raise and to discuss at this year's conference. The first interesting issue that emerged is the relationship between the private and the public sector, which everybody recognizes as an important area. However, very, very little is said about the problematic aspects of this relationship. So we wanted really to focus on this and engage participants in a discussion. For example, in many jurisdictions, nobody really knows what value should be attached to information originating from the private sector. What is the prosecutor supposed to do with this information? Another question that is very often left unanswered is, should the private sector participate in the investigation, or should it be present at the collection of evidence, and so on and so forth. We've had an interesting legal panel on this subject, and this is also an area on which the Office of Legal Affairs is going to develop further initiatives in the years to come, and that will be made known in its website. The second reason why I think being present at this conference is important is that it allowed us to launch the first two legal handbooks on illicit trade. We did official launch here. The first legal manual is a general one that covers illicit trade in general, by sector, and we really want to offer a perspective that is a broad one, that covers also various international instruments dealing with organized crime and corruption. Right? The second handbook focuses more specifically on illicit trade in tobacco products. It's also a very topical issue, and this is because illicit trade in tobacco products is increasingly a problem worldwide. And we also wanted to give practical tips to the international community in terms of how to implement the recently adopted protocol of the World Health Organization related to this issue, right? Both handbooks follow a very practical and legal approach. They are addressed to policymakers, but they can also be usefully employed by the law enforcement community. They are fully available online from the legal webpage for download. We are planning to have them translated into all Interpol official languages, and we really wanted to provide tips and advice in practice for the readers. So we really hope that this initiative will be a success and that many people will go to our webpage to read them.